Second Lieutenant Rama Raghuba Rane is on his stomach and crawling under a straw tank that is slowly making its way across a minefield. He is trying to do it at a pace that matches the speed of the tank which is above him. His legs are badly slashed from the exploding mortar and they hurt with any movement, but he ignores the pain. Concentrating instead on the massive wheels that are turning into deep rumble that is reverberating in his ears. Rana holds in both his hands thick ropes that are attached to the tank. He is using them as a signal for the tanks to stop and to move. Each time he spots a mine ahead of him, he pulls the right hand and the tank stops. After he has cleared the mine, he pulls the rope in his left hand and the tank starts moving again. The armored vehicles, the tanks are the part of his plan to attack Rajouri and stop Pakistani raiders who are intent on carnage, rape and loot. Since every second means a difference between life and death for innocent locals, speed is of the essence and Indian Army must get there as fast as it can. Rana has devised the method of moving in the minefield as the area is under constant enemy machine gun fire and his mine's clearing section is not able to work otherwise. He spots a telltale circular depression that means there is an anti-tank mine laying underneath. He tugs on the rope in his right hand. The tank above him grins to stop. Uses the finger of both of his mud-stained hands, Rana scraps the stone and rumbles from around the mine. He then gently removes the cover and reaches into the deactivating the fuse. Putting the lid back on again, he closes his eyes for a fraction of a second, heaves a sign of relief, then he tugs the rope in his left hand and starts crawling again. Second Lieutenant Rama Raghuba Rane was from the engineers unit and their job was to clear the mines and make road where there was none and help the army attack the Pakistani raiders in Kashmir. Rane with a section of 22 men was ordered to make a road for the tanks to attack Rajouri. It's 6 am on a sunny day when Rane and his section are put on mine clearing duty. Starting from Nathpur South Fort area, near Nasuira, the task is to create a safe passage for tanks so that they can move from Nasuira to Rajouri, where the raiders are attacking the civilian population. After the recapture of Jhangar, the Pakistani army flees, but not before completely destroying the national highway from Poonch to Rajouri. With no other means to reach Rajouri, the Indian troops are ordered to create their own path till Chingaz, which is an old Mughal passage to Kashmir. Second Lieutenant Rane and his section of 37 Assault Field Company are attached to Fort Dogra, which starts the advance to the Rajouri on 8th of April 1948. With an attack on Barwali Ridge on 4:30 pm but cannot go beyond it because not only the area is hilly, there are also massive roadblocks and minefields on the roads. This is when Rane and his small section is pressed into action. They start cleaning the roadblocks but it gets dark soon and they are surprised by the enemy fire. The Pakistanis have returned and are launching mortars burst at the men trying to clear the road. And at the stroke of bad luck, Rane loses his four men and he himself gets a deep cut in his thigh. But he refuses to get evacuated and only asks for a minimum first aid. Engineers lost their four men and even Rane's thigh is bleeding. So the plan to clear the road block at night gets dropped. Rane and his section returns at the dawn the next day to start cleaning the landslide again. By 10 am they have managed to clear the road block and the tanks had moved ahead. And sooner they ran into another landslide that is again cleared by the engineers by the 3 pm. The procedure continues till dusk when the tanks are halted and the men quickly dig the trenches for themselves and take cover for the night. Then around 4:45 am the next day, Rane is again on the move. Despite great risk to his life, he continues to clear the roadblocks and minefields, helping the tanks to move ahead. Slowly and steadily, they make a path for advancing troops of tanks and reaching us at 2 pm. Rane keeps working till 9 pm to open the road completely. Finally, at 11 am next day, road is open for all vehicles. But man discovered that the road from Chingaz to Rajouri is much worse. Since reports of the massacres are reaching the army, Rane and his men are ordered to make a path for the tanks along the bed of the River Tavi all the way to Rajouri. The man get to work again, brewing up the big boulders along the river side. The river follows an undulating course and often the tanks have to get in and get out of the water. Sometimes they get stuck and have to be pulled out by the engineers. On 11th April, they halt again and finally, on 12th at 6 p.m, tank reaches Rajouri. Rane had worked all these days without any rest and it's a miracle that he managed to get the man of one Kumau para and the tanks there in the Rajouri. Once the man reached Rajouri, they found it as a ghost town. They crossed two blood-soaked pits of bodies, including those of women and children, have been raped and massacred by the raiders. The arrival of the Indian Army stops violence and soon refugees start moving back to their villages. The engineers are awarded the Battle of Honor of Rajouri and Second Lieutenant Rama Raghoba Rane is awarded the Paramveer Chakra for his devotion to the duty and courage. He is among the one of the rare men who wore Paramveer Chakra alive. This was the story of the engineers and Second Lieutenant Rama Raghoba Rane in the Rajouri. I'll be meeting you in the next video. Till then, be happy, be optimistic and keep smiling. Jai Hind.